So we move on to the next session of installation. Those who have problem in installing Scilab or the CD content or the toolboxes or whatever material we had given in the guidelines email, if you have any problem, we have a GMeet. I have set up a GMeet where you people can join and you guys can ask your queries regarding that. So I'm putting the GMeet link on the chat. So you all can join there. And people who have already joined, I think they can start watching the tutorials. Maybe Rupak or Rashmi, one of you can join the GMeet. And Tushar, you can also join the GMeet and help the people there. I think most of you have successfully installed Scilab, right?
Rupak?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, there is one person who is asking a doubt. What I need is to configure the side-by-side interface. Can I get help? So can you just guide him or should I do it?
Yeah, anyways, it is possible.
See, Benedict, actually, you have to open Scilab and open the video also, whatever we have. Hope you have extracted the CD content and got the all the tutorial videos on your desktop. So open the first tutorial, whatever is to be practiced in the next session. Keep that in one side and open the Rupak, he has installed Scilab 5.5, but I remember you have insisted on 6, right?
Yeah, please install Scilab 6.5.
There is a video also in the CD content which tells you how to configure side-by-side method. You can actually see that video. Actually, Professor Kannan has told, was demonstrating that you can see 3 videos before starting. So you can start watching that videos. It has how to configure side-by-side also in that. And we request you all to install Scilab 6.1.0. If you have installed 5.5, that is not enough.
Because if you have a lower version, probably in some of the sessions, you may find some difficulties in proceeding with the tutorial or our live session. So it is better you install 6.1.0.
I think only 20 people have joined. So I think only 20 people have a problem. I think rest can start watching the 3 tutorials which Professor Kannan has told regarding the side-by-side method. It's already available in the CD content. Please start watching that. And then you may proceed with getting started on Scilab. Please make sure you have installed all the toolboxes, the GUI thing, and also the code files, the CD content, everything before we go ahead to next session. Thank you.
Yeah, most importantly, the CD content and Scilab.
So hope, Dr. Piyush, you had a email which our team had sent yesterday.
Can I speak?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I have downloaded any app. Yes, actually, I have been doing Scilab for long for our students. But I wanted to see what difficulty a normal person is like. I'm doing this fresh now. Okay. So the CD, the portion that we have downloaded as a training part, you have given us is I have made a Scilab folder. There you have given us a download folder. In download folder, you have a spoken.
Yes. So
in the spoken, it is, I think, the...
When you open that spoken folder, you may see index.html, right?
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah.
So you open it.
So
don't open the videos and all. Directly go to index.html and open it in your browser.
So we have to go to the spoken folder.
Then no, spoken, open it and there open index.html.
That's in front of me now. Thank you.
Just open it and it will open in your browser.
TV videos are there. Yeah, fine.
Yeah. Okay.
I have seen them many times. But I just
Then you go to the top and select the software and the language. Then you will get and you click on the, I think search is the button which comes. So if you click on that, you will get all the Scilab videos. You have to select the software as Scilab, and English is the only option you will be getting. So that also you select and proceed.
Thank you, I got. Thank you.
Okay, great. Thanks.
So I hope people who are here have installed everything properly, right?
Vinita, there is a request from one Mr. Prashanta Reddy.
Yeah.
He's asking, I have installed. Please share your Scilab software screen. From this, we will be sure that we have installed the necessary GUI and others.
I didn't get the question properly. You want to see...
Ma'am, please share your screenshot so that we will sure that we have installed the necessary GUI or not. Please open the software at your side. Please share that one. So that
right now you will only need the CD content and the Scilab 6.1.0. If you have both, you can start seeing the spoken tutorials.
Yeah, I have already installed those, I think yesterday only. And I tried to open the Scilab also. It is working fine. And you are talking about GUI, right, before? I'm sure whether I'm having the proper GUI or not.
We'll share the screen, sir, during that session itself. I hope everyone here has installed Scilab 6.1.0 and is ready with the CD content, right? Just say a yes on the chat.
Ma'am, are you there?
Yeah, tell me, who's this?
Ma'am, I'm Dr. Prashanta from Lollipop University. Ma'am, it's regarding the, suppose by mistake if I close this Scilab console, how to open it again?
Sorry, I didn't get your question.
If I close the Scilab console, how to get it again?
Scilab.
Yeah.
So, Rupak, Rashmi, one of you can just answer that.
No, close the console means what?
Suppose you are typing the commands right here in the command prompt. By mistake, if I close that window, how to open it again?
I'll have to see that case. What exactly?
Which OS are you using?
Windows.
Windows. Okay. So go to Start menu and type Scilab.
Okay. I need to reopen again.
Yeah, you will have to reopen it if you have closed it.
No, I didn't close the Scilab console, but in the command prompt area.
Okay. He's undocked the window.
Yeah.
Probably, and he closed it. So maybe there is a view option. Can you just explore?
There's no view here. Only file, edit, control, and application. Four options are here.
I will see. So restarting doesn't help.
It might help, but I want to know whether how can it help without restarting.
No, please try restarting if it helps. Can you please try?
Okay, I will try.
Please try restarting the system. Not the system, Scilab. Did you try restarting Scilab and see whether the console is restored?
Okay, I'm just closing and opening again.
Sir, excuse me, I have a doubt.
Yeah, let one person finish.
Yeah, it's open again.
Fine.
Yeah, without restarting, you know, how can you close it and open one more time?
Yes, I don't have an answer for that question right now.
Okay, all right.
Solved,
right. Yeah, okay, fine. Thank you.
Thanks. Yeah, ma'am.
Sir, by mistake, if I typed some other character, I could not return back to the command prompt. How could we can terminate from the previous command, sir?
Control C.
Control C. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Control C will kill the last operation.
Thank you.
Okay, for example, I open the file again. I want to see the previous commands, so what I typed before.
You press the up arrow key.
Which one?
Up arrow.
Up arrow?
Up, down, right, left, arrow keys. No?
Okay, because I close it, I can open one more time, right? I can't see anything.
No, you will still see the last commands.
No, I can't see it here because it's like loading in shell environment. That's what it is saying.
So, do you see something in the command history?
Because just now I told you, right, I just closed the command prompt, and that's why I closed the complete Skylab console and opened it one more time.
Yeah, probably but, you lost the history. Do you see the history on the right side? There is a command
history. No history. That's the question.
So when you close the console, it deleted your history, basically.
So I can get it back?
I don't see a way of getting it back.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's okay. All right. Thank you.
So all of you who have problem with installation of FOT, FOT will not be needed on the day one and day two. So don't worry about it. I will give you some additional instructions so that it will also accommodate people who have some special cases. And we'll get FOT installed on your Scilab. Don't worry about it. So right now you concentrate on only finishing the spoken tutorials. Okay. So by the end of today, I will add some more instructions to the instruction sheet that we had said earlier for installation of FOT. I will add a few more instructions. Maybe if you follow those instructions, you will be able to install some alternate way of installing. Okay, so we'll break for lunch.